Satan. So because of the way Satan has been presented and what you and I have been referred to as Satan, it became very difficult to acknowledge who Satan is. And because of that, we end up in a wrong fight why Satan is defeating us. And some of this wrong misunderstanding we have about Satan is because of the movies we watch and how Satan has been presented in the movie. And that's why we say, oh, this is Satan. And that's the reason why some of you are fighting a wrong Satan all the days of your life. Why Satan, the whole Satan himself, is, you know, defeating and beating you down. Okay? First of all, I just need to let you understand, most of us who watch Nigerian movies and so many movies that presented Satan as a human or a person. So most of you watch those witchcraft movies and so many movies, and because of this, you misunderstood Satan. But if I tell you the truth, Satan has been defeating you all the days of your life, because the person you claim to be Satan is not. So tonight we'll be dealing with the word, how do I acknowledge this enemy and then rebuke him from my life? Well, another word for Satan means the Antichrist. Okay, so there are many people who believe that the Satan or the Antichrist is yet to come in a human form. That's what many people are expecting him to be. Imagine Satan to be some kind of scary and very scary personality. That's how many people see Satan to be like. So all their life with prayer up and down, they are fighting Satan with prayer, how to overcome Satan, how to pull Satan, you know. And like I said, that is a wrong fight. Satan is not yet to come into the world. He has been here since Jesus Christ left the earth. And therefore, you and I will be wrong to think Satan is that kind of scary person you saw in a movie or whatever. No, no. Satan has been in the world for so long. Satan has been here with us, like I said, for so long. And the only reason why you and I cannot identify him is the fact that out of our human wisdom, we are expecting him to be in a very scary form, like the movies we watch and the kind of, you know, operations we see. And that's what many people feel like. That is how they're expecting to see Satan before they can see. But as I said, Satan has been here for a long time, and he has been defeating and beating us down for a long time. And with such a mentality, some of us has failed already, because everything about the spirit must be judged according to the spirit, not according to our human perspective. Okay, so we must judge and explain things. We must judge and explain things according to the Spirit, which is the Word of God. Remember, anytime I say Spirit, I'm referring to the Word of God, because in the Word of God dwell the Spirit of God. So as I said, for you to understand Satan and his personality, we need to judge it according to the things of the Spirit, because Satan is not a human you should be expecting. Satan is not a human in a human form or in a some kind of spiritual form you should be expecting. He is here with us. Now let's open to the Bible. Go to the Bible in the book of 1 John 4 verse 1 to 3. Look at what he says. Hereby know ye the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confess that Jesus Christ comes in the flesh is of God. And every spirit that confess not that Jesus Christ come in the flesh is not of God. And this is the Antichrist, whereof you have heard that it should come, and even now he is already here in the world. Do you see that? He said the enemy is not yet to come, but the enemy is already here. So the Antichrist, who is Satan, is a preaching. Now think not very carefully. Like I said, Satan If you're expecting Satan to be in a scary form, in a form of a human like we watch in a movie with those kind of fire and those kind of operation, then you have already missed it. And that's the reason why you and I are fighting the wrong fight. We are expecting Satan in some way before we know this is. But the scripture really teach different than what we believe in. Okay, the scripture in 1 John 4:1-3 says, Satan can be acknowledged in preaching. Satan can be acknowledged in word. Okay? So the Antichrist or Satan can be discovered through preachings that drive away people's focus from Christ. And the purpose of the Satan or the purpose of the Antichrist is not to persecute people. The purpose of Satan is not to persecute people that you know, oh, this is satanic. No, the purpose of Satan is not to persecute people from hearing or preaching Christ, but to cunning or to drive people's focus from Christ. So the Antichrist does this by preaching another message to point people's mind from Christ. So to discover the devil is not to look for him in a human form. To discover the devil is not to look for him the way we saw or we have watched in a movie. The devil is not, listen, the devil is not a human for you to be searching for him. The devil dwells in a message. Just as Paul said, the gospel is the power of God unto salvation, so it is when it comes to the devil. The devil is in the message. So the devil can be discovered in a message. So the message you hear is the power of the devil to deform you. That's the reason why many people, their life have been destroyed because of the message they discover. And just like I said, many of us are looking for Satan in a human form, not knowing that they have already embraced Satan because he's also a body of a message. Satan is a body of a message. It's a wrong message. Now let's look at more scriptures, okay? Now look at 2 Corinthians chapter 11. 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 3 to 4. 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 3 to 4. Look at what he says. He said, but I fear, lest by any means, as the serpent beguiled Eve through his subtlety, so your mind should be corrupted from the simplicity that is in Christ. For if he that come and preach another Jesus, whom we have not preached, or if you receive another spirit which we have not received, or another gospel which you have not accepted, you might well bear with him. So do you see that? To discover Satan, you don't need to look for him in a human form. Satan is in a message. That's why I'm saying many of us are fighting wrong fight all the time, not knowing that the enemy is already beating us down through the message we have received. So how do you discover Satan? You discover Satan in the message. You discover Satan in the gospel. It's also a gospel. Just as Christ is not a human that you can see, the same apply to the Satan. The same apply to the devil. The devil is not a human, you see. The devil is in a message. This is the reason why people who embrace wrong message shall be destroyed by the same message they have received. This is the reason why many of them, they have already, their life has already been destroyed. Meanwhile, they are fighting Satan in a wrong place. Are we getting it? Satan is in what? Wrong message. So how do we identify Satan? Now, to identify Satan, you must first identify the the Spirit, which is Christ. So because you need a spirit, if you don't have right spirit, how will you know the wrong spirit? So how do we know the wrong spirit from the right spirit? First of all, before you know, you need to first learn. The Bible says Jesus is the author and the finisher of our faith. So Christ is the foundation of the ministry. Okay, so you need to watch how Jesus Christ done the ministry for you to understand, to use this to judge another ministry, to find out whether the realm you are in, is it a wrong message or right message? Because just as I said, many people are fighting wrong Satan all the time. Meanwhile, Satan has already beaten them down. They are fighting the wrong fight always. So we can only discover the enemy in a message just as we discover Christ in the message, okay? So Christ is the body of the gospel. So Antichrist is also a body of its gospel. So any gospel that comes to take your eye from Christ onto yourself, or any gospel that comes to point you to yourself, that is how you identify the devil. The devil does not come in a scary form like many of us are, you know, expecting him to be. The devil dwells in the gospel. And just as I said, many of them has already embraced the devil and at the same time fighting the devil, not knowing that the way of your freedom dwells in a message and your bondage also is in the message. So this idea about demonic Satan, they are all in what? In the form of a message. The manifestation only takes place because you embrace the message. Now look at Ephesians. Come to the book of Ephesians chapter 6. So go to the book of Ephesians chapter 6 and let's read from verse 10. We are reading from verse 10, Ephesians chapter 6 verse 10, and I'm reading from the NIV version. It says, finally, brethren, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's deception or the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Therefore, put on the full armor of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground, and after you have done everything to stand. Stand firm, then, with the belt of truth, buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And verse 18, and pray in the Spirit on all occasions. You see, pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. In King James Version, he said, put all the armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. So just as I said, you can only identify Satan in what? In a preaching. Now you may ask, Philip, how can I detect the Antichrist since every preacher is mentioning the name Jesus, Jesus? How do I know this is right and this is wrong? Well, in the year 2019, I asked God the same question about how do I identify the wrong from the right, because everybody is mentioning Jesus. Now, look at the book of Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. Hebrews 12 verse 2, he said, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. The gospel we are preaching is not something new. We are not starting something new. He said, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. So the Lord Jesus Christ is the beginner, the author, and the finisher of all ministries on this earth. In other words, whatsoever we are doing today, the gospel we are preaching today, Christ has already done it. He has already set the foundation for us to walk in. He has already built the foundation. Now look at 1 Corinthians 3:11 said, for other foundation can no man lay than that is laid, which is what? Christ Jesus. For there is no any other foundation anybody is going to lay, because the work is already done. Jesus has already built the foundation. All we need to do is to work on it. We are not building a new gospel foundation. We are already doing what Jesus has already left for us to do. Therefore, to identify the wrong Jesus from the right is not the name. This means that whatsoever the Lord Jesus Christ did not preach, whatsoever Jesus Christ didn't preach, you are not to preach. If Jesus did not preach, for example, on the area of tithing or collecting tithe from people, you should not dare to preach or collect it. Why? Because he said Christ is the foundation. Christ is the foundation. You understand? Christ is what? The foundation. So if that's why I said, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher. So we are saying, if the only way we can detect the Antichrist is in the message. And the purpose of the Antichrist is not to come and slaughter you, no. The purpose of the Antichrist is to put you in bondage by taking your focus from what Jesus has done. So one of the areas is to put you in bondage so that you cannot experience the freedom of Christ. So any message that does not bring you freedom is what? Antichrist. It's the message that is the appearance of Satan. So if whatsoever Christ didn't teach, I'll be wrong if I take it as a doctrine. Whatsoever Christ didn't teach on, it is wrong to teach on. So Jesus is the fulfillment of the entire Bible, and therefore using the Bible to explain Jesus is also a failure. Because there are so many people say, well, it is quoting here, it's quoting here, it's quoting here. No. We need to know the difference. Last time I was teaching my mentorship class, know the difference between the covenants. Anybody can quote the Bible to use you. The difference is about covenant. So preaching the Bible can sometimes put people into error, because people know how to quote, but the truth of the matter is that a lot of them put us in bondage. And there are men and women today, their life is a mess. Let me tell you, if you have been in Christ, okay, you have been in fellowship, you spend your entire life in Christ, and the next thing you could see is that your finance, your everything just destroyed. Ever since you came to Christ, you were well built. I mean, your finance was okay, but the moment you came to Christ, your finance, your everything just messed up. Your life is messed up. It means the kind of message you encounter that day is demonic. And the Bible said the enemy comes to destroy. So what destroyed your finance ever since you came to Christ is that the devil is what you have embraced. The message you consume was demonic, and that message came to destroy you. But the message of Christ came to make us fruitful. And because most of you were expecting the devil in the wrong way, not knowing that the devil is the message. That's why John was telling you that do not believe every spirit. You know, he called the preaching a spirit. So under every denomination carries spirit. Let me tell you, the word we are preaching carries spirit. Whether you believe it or not, it carries spirit. It can either affect you or destroy you. So there are many people who were financially okay, but the moment they came to Christ, their finance, their marriage, everything became messed up. Why? It is because of the message. The devil is in the message. So how to identify the wrong? Because every minister is calling Jesus, Jesus. So to identify the fake Jesus is not in the name. Hearing the name of Jesus does not mean the Lord Jesus is there. So when you hear somebody preaching Jesus, Jesus, that doesn't mean Jesus is there. Because most of us have been deceived with the name Jesus. Because the moment you hear the name Jesus, okay, I think this is that God is here. That is wrong. It is not the name. It is not about the miracles you see there. There are many false powers out there. So seeing somebody performing miracles does not justify the fact that Jesus is there. So for us to identify the devil, because now everybody is just mentioning the name Jesus. The name Jesus, they use it to cover their evil things. And we said the devil is not a man for you to be waiting to see, like you watch in movies, like you're expecting, you watch those movies so much that it becomes your mind. So all you know about the devil is some kind of scary person, whatever. Let me tell you, the devil is in a message. He preached through men. Okay, so to identify the original Jesus is also not in how many, or for example, branches, churches, how many members or numbers of people fill in that church. That is how many people have been deceived. It's not about to identify how true or the right from the wrong. It's not about membership. It's not about how plenty people are. It's not about the congregation, how well decorated that's it, and they mention Jesus and say, well, Jesus is here. No. Building does not justify that the Lord Jesus Christ is there or is with somebody because the person has so many influence. For us to identify the real Christ from the fake Christ, you know, the Bible talk about the Antichrist and the original Christ. So it just as in currency, we have fake money and original money, the same when it comes to Christ. And there are many people who are serving the fake one all their life, because in today's state, people hate truth. And like I said, especially the women, many of them, they have been destroyed. Their life, their marriages, you know, let me tell you, the way to know whether the truth, whether you are hearing the truth or false, you can see the effect in your own life, the effect in your family, the effect in your finance. That is when you know whether are you surely with the truth or not, because the enemy comes to destroy, Christ comes to impact. So most, especially most of women, their marriages, their family are being destroyed because of this particular false Christ. So to identify the rare Jesus or the rare Christ and the fake Christ is by looking into the preaching. Listen, it is by looking into the preaching. You need to judge the preaching, because Satan dwells in preaching. Get thee behind me, Satan. Yet it was Peter talking. How did Jesus identify Satan? He identified Satan in the words of Peter. So most of us are waiting to see Satan in some kind of form, some kind of or manifestation before. And the same way the church, you know, misunderstood the Holy Spirit. The same way they misunderstood who the Holy Spirit is the same way they misunderstood who Satan is. So the confusion has really brought a lot of distraction in many people their life. To some people, if they don't see manifestation, the Holy Spirit is not there. Please get my book, How to Identify the Holy Spirit. Okay? So, the fake Jesus can be identified through their message. You can see it in a message. And just like I said, many people's life have been destroyed because they are expecting Satan in some kind of form. The preacher is pointing you to the witchcraft in your family and so on. So for you, you don't know that Satan is already dealing with you through the knowledge. just as I said, the original can be identified through the message, just like Paul said. He said, if anyone, let me read that scripture back again. Let's go back. Let me read that scripture back. Let's see 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 4. He said, for if he that cometh and preacheth another Jesus. Now, how do you see it? He said, for if anyone come and preaches. You see, preach is. So it can be preached. Satan can be preached. That's why he call it that another Jesus. Satan is in a message. The only reason why you can't see him is because Jesus' name has been tied to it. So Paul in 2 Corinthians chapter 11 verse 3 said, but I fear lest by any means as Satan or corrupted if mine, so your mind should also be corrupted from the simplicity of the gospel. It drives the believer's mind from the simplicity of the gospel into another thing. As I keep saying, let me just go to Facebook Live and I become live and I start, buy water and salt. And I try to, prophesy. I say, oh, there's a woman, I see you struggling with a financial problem. I can see you. Guys, I can have plenty people live on my Facebook Live, even on this Zoom meeting. Do you see that? Satan comes, the message of Satan comes to clutch you with problem. So Paul said, but I fear lest your mind will be corrupted, the same thing happened to Eve, from what the simplicity of the gospel. So how do we identify Satan? First sign that Satan is present is that he takes people's mind from the simplicity of the gospel into another. And Paul said in verse 4, for if anyone come and preach another Jesus. So you see, Satan can only be preached. It is not a human you can see. It can only be preached. That's why he said, if anyone come and preach. So we can identify the enemy in preaching. But most of us fail to acknowledge him because the name Jesus has been used to cover it up. And he said what? Wherever you see Satan, it drives the people's mind from the simplicity of the gospel. They see the gospel as so simple. Today, people see the simplicity of this gospel as so simple, so cheap to understand, so cheap to receive. But I like to tell people about problems. Tell them about their family. Tell them you see some spirit in their marriage. Trust me, you are the best gospel minister. That is what people love to hear. It is taking your mind from the simplicity of the gospel. The gospel is so simple. And the minister is also simple. But the receiver, the ignorant receiver, see it as so cheap to receive. No, this one is so simple. And that is the reason why the believer is being bullied by Satan. So most of them are fighting Satan, not knowing that Satan is already in their conscience and Satan is already what they receive. There are so many homes that have been destroyed because of their message. So many finances that have been collapsed. So many businesses have been collapsed because of the message. They receive Satan and they consume Satan and they receive him in their heart, and then the message destroy them. So Paul is saying Satan can only be preached to you. Satan is not a human to be presented to you. So guys, how do we identify this false Christ from the original one is in the message? So those messages about tithes, about enemy must die, about if you do this, you do this, they are what we call satanic messages. This is the reason why you don't need to take light on error. Because error can destroy you. Then Paul said, I am not ashamed of the gospel, for it is the power of God. So the truth is the power of God to change your life. Likewise, The lies is also the power of Satan to deform and to destroy your life. So Satan is not a human for you to be searching for. Satan is in a gospel. It is wrapped. It's a body of a message. And many people have already received him. Many people have already consumed him. Many people have already been destroyed because of the message. So Satan is not a human to be expecting. He is in the gospel. Many people add him. Many people bring him into the message. Now look at 2 Corinthians 3:17. It said, now the Lord is that spirit, and where the spirit of the Lord is, there is a liberty. So the sign that I am preaching through, the first sign you see is liberation, liberty. Now this liberty is what many believers have defined as cheap, and so simple to believe. The reason why there is difference between the religious ministers and the true ministers is that the receiver see the true minister as this message is so simple. So you tell him you are blessed. No. Just tell me that I should do something to be blessed. Just tell me something to do so that my finance can, you know, they take God as some kind of ritual. That is the devil there. You tell people you are the righteousness of God. They feel like, no, this is too cheap. Tell me to do something. I want to do something. That is the message people want to hear. They want to hear message that when they, after the service, they'll feel fearful. That is when you know that, well, this man of God is full of fire. Not knowing that what you are feeding them with demonic message. And the same message will destroy them. So how do we judge what we hear? The Bible says, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of your faith. In other words, Jesus has already built the ministry. The ministry we are doing, he has already done it. So if something the disciples in Christ didn't preach it and anybody is building it, it is an error. So if what you see being done, it's not what Jesus did in his ministry, that means it is not original Jesus. Satan is in the message, and I'm preaching this message so that your eyes may open. Satan is not a man you should be looking for. Satan is not some kind of scary beast you should be looking for. Satan is in the message you need to judge it. And I said many people has already consumed him. He lives in a message. He lives in a lie. That's why when you believe a lie, the lie will deform you and the lie will lead you to destruction. The gospel comes to free you from the consciousness of fear, condemnation, death. So if what you are receiving is full of condemnation, guilt, and death, that is the realm of the devil. The presence of devil is what? Fear. The presence of devil is condemnation. The presence of devil is guilt. These are signs you should know that the devil is here. So all the messages you are hearing, that the reason why your finance is this and that, and is because your family background is this and your family background is that, is the message of an antichrist. That doesn't mean I may not have the knowledge, the word of wisdom to tell you what is wrong. I may have the word of wisdom to tell you what is wrong, and after we receive the word of wisdom, the next thing is to rebuke it, not to make you feel, not to tell you, you know what, you need to do this and do that and do that. That is what is called demonic. So you should not move by the name Jesus, praise Jesus, then you feel like Jesus is dead. No. The original Jesus who walked on earth, first of all, didn't take any tithes. Giving his spiritual, I keep telling you, giving his life, tithing his death. Because tithe, whether you pay or you must pay. If you don't pay, you are cursed. Tithe is for slaves. It is only slaves who pay. So I am telling you this, that the message is how you detect Satan. That's why Paul said Satan is a preaching. He said, if anybody come to you and preach another Jesus. Now, Apostle John also once said, if anybody comes to your house without this message, do not give the person a seat to sit in your house. If you do, you share his evil way. Can you imagine, just by sitting down and listening to wrong message, the Bible says you share iniquity with a person. So I want you to understand, for us to know who Satan is, you need to pay attention to what you hear very carefully. The original Jesus speaks the truth and says, you are blessed, go to work and it will flow. He tells you, you are the presence of God and you carry the Holy Spirit in you because you are the temple of God. Also, the original Jesus came to tell you what you have inherited. The fake one came to you to tell you what you can do to get. And I said, Satan doesn't come like you watch in a movie, come to destroy, come to, you know, kill you, you in the midnight, they do something. Those are all movies, but that's not how Satan operates. Satan does not have power to kill you. Satan doesn't have power to just appear and take your life. No, he doesn't do. In fact, the first people who ever lived in the Garden of Eden, who have never seen, who were righteous, like they have never seen, how did Satan approach them? Lies. That was how he conquered them. So the way Satan has been presented to you in denomination, like a way that when you sleep, he just come destroy you, do this, kill you, do this. That is all lies. That is all deception. That is not how he operates. Satan cannot do anything without your cooperation. The way Satan starts to conquer you is by lies. He set a lie for you. So the moment you begin to follow the lies, the deception, that is the beginning of you being trapped by the enemy. That's why Paul says, put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the lies of the devil, because the lies of the devil is the power of the devil. So the reason why some of you could not identify the devil is because of how the devil has been presented to you and how you watch in movie. But Satan is in the message, is in the gospel. And one of the signs that you have already encountered and Satan is working through you is that it affects your marriage, it affects your work. Like things will not be flowing the way it should flow. One of the ways to see that you have received the message of truth is that the message of truth affects your life. And there are some that don't have either Satan or they are just in the middle, and that's just the same as walking in the realm of the devil. So if what you hear is not what Jesus has finished, flee from me. That is fake Jesus. The fake Jesus is the one who demands the truth. It's not in the name Jesus. Like you hear in a ministry, you hear Jesus. That's okay. I think this ministry is preaching Jesus simply because they hear the name Jesus. That's all. That for some people, that is the truth is there, because I can hear the name Jesus there. But Paul said there is another Jesus. So in conclusion of this message, guys, we need to pay carefully attention to what you hear. Some of you respect men of God so much that when you see this is error, you feel like, okay, I know this is error, but it still is my man of God. The Bible says, do not be deceived. Evil communication corrupt good manners. And just as I'm saying today, there are many ministers who are preaching the truth in simplicity, with all humility and with all love. And we see it as so cheap, as so simple. Just tell me to do something, then I feel like you are preaching the right message. That is how many people believe. And you know, like I said, many people who have received these fake messages, because Satan dwells in it, their marriages has messed up, their businesses has messed up, their finances mess up. You know, the presence of the enemy destroy everything you own and corrupt everything you own and rob your bank account. It take away everything. So because the thing come to, you know, take from you. It is always in demand with curse attached to it. If you don't do it, you'll be cursed. If you don't do it, the Lord will not bless you. If you don't do it, life will be hard for you. There is always curse attached to that message. And I keep saying it is time for us to train people, because it's enough of preaching, enough of going to church. It is time to, because many people's life have been destroyed. They hate the gospel. Trust me, many people hate the gospel so much because of how robbed they have been robbed. I know many of them who became atheists today. because of what they have been promised. Like when you come to God, he'll give you this. That is not true. If you are not here because of the truth, you are just wasting your time. Because the gospel is not about come to God and he will give you a man to marry. Come to God and he will give you a woman to marry. Come to God and he will give you a job. If you don't understand the purpose of the calling, then I can encourage you, just rest. Put yourself somewhere and rest, because the gospel is not about come and God will give you a job. God will give you, because that's the mentality, the reason why many people come to Christ, and that's why we have fake brethren. The gospel is about, the gospel only supply one thing, life. So all those messages about come, you receive husband, come, you receive job, come, you receive this, they are all fake. And that is the fake messages. That doesn't mean God doesn't, we pray and God works miracle. The gospel, miracle, they are just byproduct. They are not the gospel. So guys, the way we detect, the way you detect the devil is a message. Some of us are looking at the devil. We are searching for the devil in the wrong places. The devil just is among us. The Bible says he's already here and he is in the preaching. And most of us have been attending those messages. Those services, we have been attending them and we have been consuming them. And our life has been a mess ever since. We have never seen any change. Like, there has been so much struggle in a Christian life because of the message. There have been so much bondage and so much. There is no freedom for now. If you hear some of the believers, their story, you just cry. You know why? Because they consume an error. So to end this message, all I'm saying is that we can detect Satan in a message. Those simple messages you call too simple, they are the truth that will change you. They are the truth that Paul said it is the power of God to transform your life. And those are the messages people don't like. This is the reason why when you hold a meeting, you hold a program, you hold Zoom meeting, you can see very few. And you know what? That is the truth, and you need to keep your focus and keep preaching. Noah preached and only his family attended, only his family got saved, and the heaven, the creator acknowledged him as a preacher of righteousness. So you don't preach, and some of the time, most of us got discouraged because we are judging. We saw some denomination feel so much that we say, like, how come I'm preaching? Let me tell you, Jesus Christ preached the truth to the point that everybody left. And he told his disciple, are you also going to, just because of truth? So truth is so simple. And truth is what you need. Lies, where the devil dwells in, come. That's why when the devil encountered Jesus, what was the first thing he was promising him? In Matthew chapter 4, he was promising him power. He was promising him things. He was promising him material things. These are how you detect devil. You understand? So many of us are looking at the devil in the wrong places. The devil just dwell right in the midst of us. The devil is the message of promises and big things. The devil is the messages of material things. The devil is the messages about monies. The devil is the messages that come, and the Lord, that is the, you know, that's how denomination, most of denomination are built, and a lot of them are there not because of truth, but because of things. And many of them, life have been destroyed. Their marriages mess up, businesses mess up. And then they are blaming God. I thought this person is praising Jesus because he was missing the name Jesus. It is not about the name. It's about the content. Truth is not a name. Truth is a content. Truth is a testimony. Truth is not a name. Truth is a testimony that comes to clothe you with the righteousness of God. Truth comes to put upon you the beauty of heaven. Truth comes to take away your guilt and condemnation. Where there is truth, there is liberty. Where there is lies, there is bondage. This is the reason why when you encounter lie, it all the time put death on you. Lies, when you receive the message of the devil, you will be encountered full of death. Full of death. So family, the way we detect the devil is in the message. The way we detect the truth is in the message. So the moment we begin to know this, we'll be able to awake into the truth. Because like I said, many people are in their houses. Many people are tired of this thing we call preaching, because they have been corrupted. And it is time for us to go there and reframe and re-put the message well, because many people has used the name of God to corrupt everything, abuse many, rob them, empty their bank account, destroy them, make them feel like they are useless. And that's why today many people hate this message we are preaching. But we should not get tired. We are sent there and we need to be strong. Jesus said a time was coming when even people forsake the faith. And these are the time we are in. And it's time you need to stand strong. The gospel come to clothe you with righteousness, to clothe you with heavenly eternal life. And that's the purpose of the gospel and nothing more. Any other thing we receive, they are just benefit. They are just byproduct of the gospel. They are not the gospel. Therefore, if anybody preach the gospel to you in the name of business, money, I am sorry, that is demonic. That is exactly what the devil was promising Jesus. And that has nothing to do with our Father. That has nothing to do with the gospel. That has nothing to do with the original gospel. And you need to vomit all those junk and pursue the right gospel, because the right gospel is so simple and it seems cheap, but it takes a life to make it so simple. The gospel is so simple. Adam and Eve, they were just enjoying life, so simple life, until the enemy came and said, you know what, you can be better than this. I can, when you do this, you can get better. So the message of the devil always come with promises, human promises, material promises, worldly promises. These are how you detect devil. Any question?